Well, I think the problem is that if you allow people to begin tampering with the original data, pretty soon you've lost the original data. And you don't really know what you've got at the end of it. It's sort of the Wikipedia problem. As long as you allow people to keep making changes, not everybody makes correct changes. But if you just concentrate on what was originally published, okay, you can go back and check it because you know that it was there. And there's no question about whether someone has misinterpreted it in the meantime or changed it in the meantime, you know that you have that original archive. If you want to allow people to take a more communal view of it, then you should set up a separate database, some separate way in which you allow third-party annotation, you allow other people to change it. They can perhaps leave their signature and show what was done. But if you don't like the way it turns out, you can always go back to the original, start all over again. There are two aspects to open access. So there's open access to data, to sort of primary data. You would like to have as much access to the primary data as you can, because very often one's interpretation of the primary data changes depending upon what you know. Usually when the original data is obtained, you don't have this extensive knowledge that might allow you to interpret it to its full. But in 10, 20, 30, 50 years, we will know so much more that we can probably then go back and look at this original data and perhaps interpret it in much more sensible ways. And I think this is why access to the literature, the published literature, is so important. That if we don't really know what it is we know, if we don't have access to the stuff that all of these other scientists have done before us, the chances of our making the breakthroughs and making the leaps that are going to allow science to press even further forward are going to be missing. You know, I think you know as well as I do, if I asked you to go and find the origin of some word, it's very difficult in the absence of having the complete Oxford English Dictionary around, where you've got archivists who've done it all for you. It's difficult to go back and find this old stuff. You really need to be a specialist. But as soon as something's available online, very easy to get there and to look at it. And the problem with allowing a private operation like commercial publishers to do it is that typically they will not let you search with the tools that you've developed. They want you to search with the tools that they've developed. And that's not satisfactory because half the time they don't have the right tools. The creativity in making tools is out in the scientific community. I was at a meeting in Jordan last year among some young people from Palestine, from Israel, from Jordan, who were getting up and talking about their day-to-day existence and how they thought things could change. And I can tell you, the things they said made so much sense by comparison with what the adults who are currently running the show were saying, that you said, well, you know, why don't we put these guys in charge? They clearly have a much better idea about how to solve the problems than these old people do. What happens is that as you get older, it becomes more and more difficult for you to really think newly and creatively about stuff because you hear all the dogma that has come forward. People have decided, oh, this is the way it should be. It's very easy, you know, you say, oh, yes, this is the way everything is, because as you get older, you often don't have time to go back and really check everything. And so you become imbued with the dogma, and you think that your way of thinking and your way of doing things is the right way to do stuff. And so, you know, maybe you get a lot of money and you bring some young people in, but they don't work on their projects, they work on your projects. And so they don't have the freedom to be creative and the freedom to challenge and do all of the experiments, you know, that I would go and say, oh, this is stupid, you shouldn't be doing that. They should be empowered to do those stupid experiments, because this is how the big discoveries get made.